Hello friends, this video on environmental issues part 9 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. So this was one aspect. So sewage was one serious cause of water pollution. So let us look at another aspect called algal bloom. Now have you ever seen an algal bloom? What is an algal bloom? It is derived from algae. Now you would have seen that in many lakes or in many ponds. Like you do not get to see the water. The topmost surface is covered with a thin layer of algae, green algae. A swamp kind of a structure is seen on the surface of the lakes. So that is known as algal bloom. And I'm sure you would have seen it sometime or the other. So this is excessive growth of algae on the water surface, which imparts a color to the water body. So in fact, you know, and sometimes if it is a small pond or a small lake, sometimes the growth is so intense that you do not get to see water anywhere. So the entire surface is covered by a green carpet if it is the growth of green algae. So you hardly get to see water. So this is known as algal bloom. And here in this picture, you can see how algal bloom happens. So do you get to see water much? Not really. So everywhere you see this green colored structure. It is like a green carpet. So this can happen not only in the freshwater bodies, but also in marine water bodies like sea and ocean. Now, what causes the discoloration? Why the color of the water changes? This changes due to the presence of pigmented cells in high density. So huge amount of pigmented cells are present, and that pigment gives the different color to the water. Now there are many algae which cause these kind of algal bloom. One very common algae which cause this is dinoflagellates. So dinoflagellates are red algae, and they cause an algal bloom which is more popularly known as the red tides. So dinoflagellates, and they cause red tides. So basically there, instead of the green carpet, you can see a thin red carpet on the surface of the water. Now the question is, what causes this algal bloom? So the cause of algal bloom is excess of nutrients. Now as I said, nutrient is something which is required for growth and development of every living organism. Now in a very similar way, this algae also, they grow, they need nutrients for growth. Now when they get excess of nutrients, then the growth also becomes excessive. So due to the excess of nutrients, which nutrients, back to specifically nutrients like phosphates. And from where do they get these nutrients like phosphates? Phosphates are present in high concentration in fertilizers. So therefore in agriculture, when fertilizers are used in excessive amount, what happens if immediately after application of fertilizers, if it rains or if fertilizer application is followed by irrigation, it often happens that the fertilizer gets washed away and it reaches the nearest water body, maybe the nearest pond or the nearest river. So now the river water has a lot of fertilizer, and fertilizers are rich in phosphates. Now due to the presence of a lot of phosphates in water, these algae start to grow, and they, since they get excessive nutrients, they grow, excessively. And due to this excessive growth of algae, a complete layer of algae is formed on the surface of the water. So excess of carbon and nitrogen also favors algal growth. So that they are also another factors, like presence too much of carbon or too much of nitrogen. So they also support algal growth. Also sodium bicarbonate is another chemical which act as a catalyst. That is, it increases the rate of formation of algal bloom. Now these algal blooms, they need lot of nutrients in the form of phosphates, carbon or nitrogen. They need sunlight. They also need slow moving water. Now if the water is continuously moving very fast, then the formation of algal bloom doesn't happen that properly. So these are some of the factors which are required for the formation of algal bloom. Now what are the effects of algal bloom? What would happen if algal bloom is formed? Now some of the effects are toxic to humans and animals. Now if there is a river on which algal bloom is formed, it is definitely not advisable to use that water for any of your drinking purposes or cooking purposes. That's because the entire water has turned toxic due to the presence of excess of these nutrients. It kills aquatic life. Now, it is something like the entire river is being blocked by the formation of algae. So, it is all algae everywhere. So, the entire aquatic ecosystem gets blocked and even the aquatic life gets killed because the water is polluted. Increases treatment costs for drinking water. Now, in case, let us suppose that river which is situated there in your town or in your vicinity, if that is the only source of water for the survival of people in that village, in that case, you just cannot ignore the water of that river. So, what you will have to do, you will have to treat that water to remove all the undesirable substances from it and then use it for drinking purposes. Now, this treatment of water will incur high costs. So, that means economically it will not be a wise decision, but then since you don't have a choice, you will have to incur the high treatment costs. So, these are some of the harmful effects of algal bloom.
Thank you. Please visit www.examfeo.com to watch more educational videos with a better experience. Please do not forget to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel for latest updates. Thank you once again.